Hello and welcome to the Google Analytics tutorial series. I'm Matt Landers, and in this tutorial, we'll take a deep dive into Google Analytics reporting using the Google Analytics demo account. We'll dive into the different types of reports, show you how to navigate them, and how to customize reports for your business. If you don't know what the demo account is, you can jump over to our tutorial on the demo account to learn about it and get access. Okay, so rather than talking about the reports, let's jump into the demo and take a look. All right, we're on the homepage in the property for the demo account for the Google Merchandise Store. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the reports, we're gonna poke around where I'll define different things and show you how to customize reports so you can get to the information you need to make good business decisions. All right, all we're gonna do is go to the left here and we're gonna click on reports. And the first place we're gonna be taken to is the reports snapshot. Now this is a special report. It's like a conglomeration of all the different reports where we can get a really quick view of the information in those reports and then decide what we wanna dive into and investigate. So at the top here, we have a summary card that shows us how many users we have, how many of those are new users, what their engagement time is. And as we scroll down through here, we'll see more and more summary cards. For instance, this one is our user acquisition summary card. It shows us where we're acquiring new users. And we can tell here that most of our users are coming from organic search. And then we'll see on some of these cards, we have a link here. This takes us to the detailed report for that summary card. And we'll dive into that detailed report in just a minute. All right, so this is the report snapshot. Next, let's look at the real-time report, which is the other thing that we can see over here in the navigation. If we click on the real-time report, this is the one place where we can see current activity happening on our website. So these events are coming through in real time, and these are the events that have happened in the last 30 minutes. Now, most of the time, the events that come through need to be processed by Google Analytics before they show up into reports. But the real-time report is a special report where we can see what's happening right now at a glimpse. And in the past, we've used this in other tutorial series videos in order to sanity check our tagging setup and make sure that we're sending data through, because we can go in and see the events that are coming through and the parameters and the values for those parameters, like we just saw with the event name and count. All right, I'm not gonna dig in much here because we've used this very extensively in the past, but let's look over in the left in our navigation and see what else we have there. All right, we have different collections of reports. We have our lifecycle collection and our user collection. Then under there, we have different topics. We have acquisition, engagement, monetization, and demographics and tech and user. Now you might have other collections here as well, like the business objectives collection. This is all customizable, which we'll look at later. All right, let's go ahead and dive into one of our topics. Let's go to engagement. And then we're gonna go to the overview page for engagement. Now this is gonna look similar to the report snapshot in that we have a lot of summary cards here. So this gives us a high level view of the engagement on our site with these summary cards, and then we can dig into actual reports from here as well. So let's go down and see how many are page views by the different pages. All right, so this is what we have over here in our page title and screens report. This is a summary. We can see that most people are going to our homepage, but we want to dive in and see more details about that information. So we can click right here, and that'll take us directly into the detailed report for pages and screens. And you'll notice in our left-hand nav that we've been taken to that directly to that detailed report. All right, now let's look at everything on this report and how we can make sense of it and customize it so that we can get the information that we need. All right, the first thing to notice is that at the top we have two different charts. We have a line chart and a bar chart. And below that, we have a table with the raw data that those charts are based on. Now, the line chart shows us our data over time, and the bar chart shows us a summary or the totals of all of that data. Now, the timeline is determined by the date selector in the top right, which we saw earlier. And one important thing to note about this is that as we change the timeline here, that's reflected on every report that we navigate to. So if you change the 7 days, it'll be reflected in our conversions and landing page report as well, which is important so that we stay in the same context as we're looking at different numbers across different reports that we're using the same time window. All right, if we hover over our line chart, we can see the details for each day. I can see that the homepage was hit 2,929 times on May 11th. And then on the right-hand side, I can see the total number of times that the homepage was hit over the course of those 28 days. All right, that's how the charts work. Now let's scroll down to the bottom and see our table with all of our data in it. Now all of our data is based on dimensions and metrics. And we've covered dimensions and metrics in previous tutorial series videos, which you can go check out if you're not sure what those are. But basically, on the left-hand side here, we have our dimensions. And on the right-hand side where you see all the numbers, those are our metrics. Our dimensions kind of describe our metrics. For instance, our homepage here is a page title and screen class dimension that shows that our homepage was hit this number of times, and the number is a metric for the number of views. Now you can hover over the different metrics here to see the different definitions for those metrics. And then you can also sort by those metrics as well. So for instance, if I change the sorting to views per user, I want you to notice that the chart changed as well to reflect that. So now it knows that I'm looking at views per user. So we're going to get a chart that reflects that change in the data below. All right. Now that we've covered the tables and where the data's come from and how to narrow that window or expand it, let's jump in and look at how to customize a report. All right, I've navigated over to our user acquisition report, which you can find under lifecycle, acquisition, user acquisition. Now, we can't actually customize this report in the demo account because we don't have editor or administrator access. And when you edit a report or customize it, that changes it for everyone that has access to that property. So you might not want to change the default reports. You might want to create new ones. That's up to you. But in the demo account, we can't do that. But what we can do is we can add comparisons and filters. So let's do that on the user acquisition report. So we're looking at this report, and what it shows us is how we're acquiring new users. And it shows that via our different channel groupings, like organic search, ad campaigns, referrals, all of those things. We can tell that we're acquiring most of our users through organic search, direct, and cross-network. But what if we want to see how we're acquiring our mobile users? Why don't we go ahead and add a comparison for that? Let's click on Add Comparison at the top. We'll go to Device Category for our dimension. And for our value, we'll choose Mobile. Say OK, and then Apply. So now at the top, you'll see that we have two different sets of data showing. The blue will be our all users, and the orange will be only our users that are on mobile. And we'll see that this data is looking a little bit different. On the left chart, we can see how many users we're acquiring. Obviously, all users is going to be more than mobile, since mobile is a subset of all. But on the right, we get some more information that tells us a little bit more about what's happening. We can see that most of our users are coming from organic search, but for mobile, that bar is pretty low. And the largest bar for mobile is actually cross-network, which means that most mobile users are clicking on ads on other websites or in apps in order to get to our site. So let's say that we saw that our mobile users are converting more than our other users. Then we might want to drive more traffic for our mobile users. And in this case, we can see that most of our traffic for mobile is coming from cross-network ad campaigns. So maybe we could up the budget on those campaigns to get more mobile users to our site. That's just one way you can interpret this data, but you might want to dig in a little more to see if that's the right thing to do. All right, and if we scroll down, we'll see that this data is also broken out in the table below. We'll see that for every different channel grouping, we have two different rows. We have one for all users, and one for just our mobile users. Now, this table is a little bit difficult to look at because we're comparing all users to mobile. But what if we want to compare desktop to mobile? What we could do is we could go in and we could take out all users, add another comparison, go back to device category, and then this time we'll choose desktop. Say apply. So now what we have up here is our blue lines are for mobile users, our orange lines are for desktop users, and now we can compare them directly. And now it's very clear how this is playing out. On the right-hand side, we can see that our mobile users are clearly coming from cross-network, and our desktop users are kind of split between direct and organic search, which is the orange bars here. And then we can also look at that data below here. So that's how we can kind of narrow this down to show just desktop versus mobile. And we can sit here and play around with different comparisons as well to like dig deeper into this data. Now, if we click over to our traffic acquisition report, you'll notice that these comparisons stay. So they stay as we click around to different reports. We can compare our user acquisition versus traffic acquisition versus the pages and screens that they view. We can go around to all of our different reports and have those comparisons be sticky. Let's go back to our user acquisition report. Let's change this up a little. Let's get rid of our comparisons. And this time, let's just add a filter. What we want to see is only mobile traffic. So rather than do a comparison between two things, we just want to only show mobile traffic. So we'll go to our filter right under the report name, and we'll do device category, just like we did before, and we'll choose mobile. Now you'll notice that you can include or exclude this data. So I could say on exclude mobile, which would show me everything but mobile, but we're gonna keep it on include to only show mobile. I'll click apply, and then you'll notice all of our data changes, and you can't see this necessarily in the data. Like, we don't get that split view of multiple rows per channel grouping, but we know because this filter is applied that we're only seeing mobile data now. And it's very evident based on, for instance, the bar chart that now shows cross-network clearly being the way that we're acquiring these users. All right. Hopefully this gives you a good overview of how to use the comparisons and filters. And now we're going to jump over into a different property so that I can show you a little bit about how to actually customize a report in a property where we have the appropriate access. All right, let's jump over to our demo site. Okay, now we're in the property for our demo site that we've been working on throughout the tutorial series, where we do have administrator access and we can edit a report. So let's go do that and see what options are available to us. We go to reports. And for this one, why don't we go to the events report? Now the events report shows us all of the events that have been fired in the time window that we've selected, which we have last 28 days here, just like we had before. And if we scroll down, we'll see all of the different events. We have 8 different events that have been fired. And we can see that here through the dimension of the event name. And then through the metrics, we can see that we have event count, total users, event count per user, and total revenue. Now let's say that we wanted to see our conversions here. Well, we would need to edit our report to add that metric. In the top right, if you have the appropriate permissions of editor or administrator, then you'll have this pin right here to customize your report. If it's not there, then you don't have the right permissions. All right, so let's click on the pin and see what options we get. The first thing that we see is report data. This shows us the data that's being pulled in to this report. For the dimensions, we only have the event name, which we can tell here. And we're not going to mess with that because this is the events report after all. We don't want to change that dimension. That would change the purpose of this report. But we can go to metrics and then we can add a new metric. And we're going to add conversions. We'll click add. And then when we apply that, we'll see that our columns change in the bottom. Now we have a conversions column and we'll see that we have 21 conversions for our newsletter signup, which is the only event that we have marked as a conversion right now besides purchases, but we haven't received any of those. All right, that's pretty cool. We can also add filters to the report that are permanent on the report. The filters that we added earlier are temporary and they're only for us. If we had a filter here, this would be for everyone that views this report. We can also see that we have our different charts. We have a line chart and a bar chart, and we could edit those as well to change them. And we can see what template this is coming from, which is the events template. And we can create summary cards. Now, these summary cards can be placed on our overviews and on our report snapshot. We could create a new summary card, which we won't get into this right now, but you create a new summary card here, add the different dimensions and metrics that you want, and then that can be used elsewhere within the reporting interface. All right, so we've seen how we can view the reports, how they're organized, how we can make sense of that data and navigate around the reporting UI. And we've seen how we can add comparisons and filters to understand our data better without needing elevated access. And now we've seen how we can actually customize a report if we have that access, which changes it for everyone that has access to the property. Okay, hopefully this has given you a really good overview of the reporting interface and how it works. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below and join our Discord server to join our community, where we have a lot of people that are on there using Google Analytics and sharing tips and tricks with each other and asking questions and helping each other out. All right. Thank you for joining this tutorial series. And until next time, happy measuring.